Alright, so let's start with the income from house property head from understanding perspective. So whatever we have written now is the legal perspective. So let us not go into legal more, let us understand it first and then we will again start computational part. To understand computational part, you should understand and you must assume this, that assessee the tax evader, assessee tax ka chor hai. This is the assumption of this chapter, because if you don't assume this, then there is no point in learning this chapter at that depth. Okay, then overall is okay, like itna okay, this is how we compute the tax. There are 2-3 steps that you need to follow. Alright. But the assumption of this chapter is assessee tax ka chor hai. And which is the true in current environment, you can observe it all around you that everybody is earning income, okay, rental income. Even you might be paying rent. Either you are earning rent or you are paying rent, and that rent is in a cash form. And I'm 100% sure then your owner is not showing it to income tax department. Alright, that's a problem. See how income tax department has tackled this problem. First of all, there are heads of income. Okay, before going into income from house property, let's talk about heads of income. Section 14, income from salary, income from house property, PGBP, capital gain, and last one is IFOS. I was telling you every head's first section is the charging section. Section 15, section 22, section 28, section 45 and section 56 is the charging section. Every head have some condition, and if you comply with the condition, then only that head will allow you to tax income under that particular head. Overall condition is like this. In salary head we have employer-employee relationship. In house property we have two condition, house property and ownership. In PGBP we have either it has to be your business or profession, and in capital gain chapter we will be having a capital asset. There has to be a capital asset. There has to be asset. Not to have a capital gain, there has to be a capital asset. You must have asset, land, building, something. Alright, shares, debentures. If you have capital asset and if you sell that capital asset, transfer that capital asset. So sale plus, like sale or transfer of capital asset will attract capital gain. So you had land, you sold land, okay, and therefore you have to pay capital gain tax. And if you are unable to tax any income under this four head, then the any other income will be taxable under the head IFOS. So this is for balance income. Alright, if anything which is not taxable under earlier four head will become taxable under the head IFOS. Why am I telling you all these things? Please understand, majority earning population of India, majority taxpayers of India, majority tax payers and earning population belongs to salary head, salary head. So they deserve a dedicated head. There are a lot of provisions in salary. It's not salary 50,000 multiplied by 12, 6 lakh taxable. There are a lot of things that we need to discuss under the salary head. Pension, gratuity, provident fund, perquisites, allowances, bonus, incentive, commissions. Hello. Apart from salary, we are going to discuss lot of things of employee life. Am I clear? And they deserve a dedicated head. Okay. Because majority population belongs here. Then minority population, majority is in salary, then minority is in business. Majorities are employees, then minorities are employer. Every business is a unique in nature. Yes or no? Alright. And business itself is a very big thing. And we must have a dedicated section which will compute income from business or profession. Okay. Now, please understand. If a land is a source, then crop is the income. If a tree is a source, then fruit is the income. In a similar way, if a employment is a source, then salary is the income. If a house property is a source, then rent is the income. If a business is a source, then profit is the income. If a capital asset is a source, then capital gain is the income. If a debenture is a source, then interest is the income. If equity share is the source, then dividend. So every head will have this source and income relationship. There will be a source and then there will be income. There will be source and then there will be income. So if you earn interest on debenture, it will be taxable under IFOS because that is income, recurring in nature. But if you sell a debenture, earning interest on debenture is a recurring in nature. Every month it will happen. Every year it will happen. Selling debenture, Once you sell debenture, it will not be there. You understand? One time, once in a life. Yes. Hello? Once in a 20 years, once in a 10 years. How many times in a year you purchase and sell properties? Very rare.
Yes.
Very rare. But how many times you earn dividend in a year? Many times. Interest, many time. Alright. So, sir, if I earn debenture interest, IFOs, if I sell debenture, capital gain, if I earn income from crops, revenue, if I sell land, capital, if I sell fruit, revenue, if I sell tree, capital, you are getting my, if I sell source, then capital, if I earn income, then income will be taxable under forehead, income will be taxable under forehead. If I sell the source, it will be taxable under capital gain, and this is not recurring in it, this is non-recurring transaction. Exceptionally it happens, and therefore I truly believe even capital gain head should be there. Hello. So according to me, income tax must have only four heads. Which four heads? Salary, business, and capital gain. Salary, business, and capital gain. Majority salary, then minority business. Alright, and then we sell shares and debentures and properties sometime. Therefore, it is exceptional in nature, and therefore it should be taxable under capital gain. And balance all other income should be taxable under IFOs. So normal rent, normal, not rent of house property, normal rent is taxable under IFOs. Interest is taxable under IFOs. Dividend is taxable under or exempt under IFOs. Royalty is taxable under IFOs. Director fees taxable under IFOs.
Yes.
Gifts taxable under IFOs. So IFOs has the power to tax a lot of incomes, yes or no?
Yes.
Which are not taxable otherwise here. Sir, what is the speciality of rent from house property? Why do we need a dedicated head of five to seven sections? Hello? Why there is a 45 pages plus theory written in our syllabus? Hello? For computing rental income. This why should be there? You understand? Kyun kar raha hai main? Rent, if I say your father is earning 25,000 rent, you will immediately take 25,000 multiplied by 12. Okay, sir. This is my annual income from the property. Hello?
Yes.
It's that simple. Why do we need a head? See, salary, yes, there are a lot of complications, so we need a head. Business, oh my God, unlimited provisions are there, therefore we need a head. Exceptional income, therefore we need a head. Balance, everything is adjusted in IFOS. What is the speciality of house property income that it needs a dedicated head, a separate head? There has to be something special about this head. Hello?
Yes,
yes or no? Alright, the speciality of this head is the tax evasion. Speciality of the, see, you cannot hide interest on debenture, you cannot hide interest on your saving bank account, you cannot hide dividend income.
Yes.
Alright, or whether you can hide or whether you are hiding, that is another part. Issue with house property head is this: majority population is earning rental income, but they are not paying tax on it. That's a fact. See, you might not earn debenture interest. Very few people in India are earning debenture interest. Very few people are earning dividend on equity. Very few people are getting taxable gifts. Hello?
Yeah.
Alright. But rent is one of the common income that majority people are earning. Majority people are earning rental income.
Yes.
People who are owning more than one property, they are earning rental income. Sometimes people are owning in Mumbai kind of places one property, but one part of one BHK, if the, there are like four BHKs, alright, so one BHK they will give to someone else, and they are earning income in PG, paying guest. Yes or no? Alright, or in chawl system this happening, okay, on ground floor owner will stay and on first floor let out. So everywhere there is a renting income, even poorest of the poor is earning. People in chawl also, they are earning rental income. Question is, are they paying taxes? Answer is no. Alright. And therefore, this head is there. Okay. So, to tax rent, we don't need a head. A separate head. To tax a rent, we don't need a separate head. We are not taxing rent. When I say, kaunsa income taxable hoga house property mein, the obvious thing that comes from your mouth is rent. I'm telling you, rent is not taxable under house property head. Rent is not taxable. If you wanted to tax rent, then rent can be taxable even in IFRS. We don't need a head to tax a rent. Okay, we are taxing rent earning capacity. What are we taxing? Rent earning capacity. Why, sir? Why are we taxing rent earning capacity? Because SEC doesn't show rent to Government of India, and even if it shows, it doesn't show a real income. Hello? Alright. So, sir, give us a numerical example. I'll give you a numerical example. Your father has two property. One where you people are staying, in another house property where tenants are staying. Okay. This property is 103 in one flat. Okay, one building, 103. And 102 is on higher. 102 is giving 40,000 rupees rent per month. 102 is giving 40,000 rupees per month. And your father have two house properties. How many properties? Two. I told you what is the reality, you know. In reality, here you have kept tenant, and that tenant is also giving you 40,000 in cash. You are trying to tell Government of India, see government, I have two house properties and I stay in both house. Hello. I have two house properties and I stay in both house. I don't earn rent. Government say, sir, you are super rich then. Person who can stay in two different house with one family. If you are in two different family, two wives, then different level. You are different level player. But with one wife, two children, one family, you can stay in one property. And if you are staying in another property also, that means you are so rich, you are so proud about you, that we will declare this particular property as a deemed to be let out property. Hello. Owner of this property, 102, for him this property is a let out property. How much rent that owner, some other owner is earning? 40,000. So that guy is paying tax on 40,000. Your father is also earning income. That is a reality. But we don't show reality to government. Alright. So reality to government is this. Both house properties are SOP. SOP, this is also SOP. So what is SOP? Self-occupied property. Self-occupied property. Government says you as a one assessee can have only one self-occupied property tax-free. One person, one property is enough. You are having two properties, that means second property is obviously let out. Hello, it is obviously let out. Now whether it is actually let out or not, that is not none of our business. Our assumption is assessee chore. Alright, and this property is deemed to be let out. Your monthly fair rent, market rent of your property is 40,000. Your property have capacity to earn, and therefore 40,000 is taxable, sir. So 40,000 multiply by 12, you have to pay tax. Then your father will shout and say, I don't have tenant there, I don't earn rent. That's your problem. If you have two properties, that property have capacity to earn rent. You earn rent and pay tax, because you have to pay tax, that is for sure. Then your father says, it is not let out, nahi hai. Deemed to be let out. And we are not requesting, sir. We are declaring it. It's deemed to be let out. Either you show it as a let out or we will. So your father learned a lesson in year 1. Year 2 evasion. Look at the assessor, no? Year 2 evasion. Now he said like, okay, now government is declaring this as a, even if I hide it, government will declare it as a DLOP. So let me show LOP. Let me show LOP. Your father will say, but I earn rent only 2,000 rupees per month. Let out. My rent is only, hello, my rent is only 2000 multiplied by 12, 24,000 annually you tax. Hello?
Yeah.
Do we get properties in Mumbai at 2000 rupees? If you know this, then the government of India also knows this. Government will say, okay, what is the fair rent in your market? Like that market rent in that area, fair rent. So you can see 102 is paying rent how much? 40,000, all right. Then government will say, sir, 102 is paying 40,000 rupees, 103 is paying only 2,000. It's not digestible to us. You might be having big heart, but we don't have big heart. Alright, so capacity is taxable, sir. How much? Then your father will say, but I earn rent only 2,000. No, rent is not taxable under this head. Kya taxable hai? Rent earning capacity. And what is the capacity of your property? Sir, wo mera relative hai. That is your problem. Capacity of your property is 40,000 and therefore we will tax capacity. Now your father will become so frustrated and then he will show actual rent to government of India. Actually he was charging 60,000. How much? 60,000. And third year he actually 60,000 kamata hai abhi kya hai? Alright, 60,000. Now you tax capacity. Capacity is 40,000. Government will say, sir, superb sir, you are earning more than capacity. How can we tax capacity, sir? You are such a great person, sir. Okay, we will tax capacity or actual rent, whichever is higher. We have to do this, therefore this head is required. We are not taxing rent, you understood? Ha, we can tax rent also. When? When rent is more than? So in articles assume it, that rent is more than. And therefore in articleship, we pay tax on actual rent. That doesn't mean actual rent is taxable in house property. No, actual rent or capacity, whichever is. Whenever data is not available, we assume actual rent is my capacity. You assume assessi chor nahi hai. This chapter assume assessi chor hai. Hello?
Yes.
Alright. So, actual rent or capacity, whichever is higher, is taxable. Sir, how to determine capacity? Capacity. Okay, I will show you how to determine capacity. So, what I said, first the rent that you should find about the property is fair rent. What is the fair rent? Fair rent is the market rent. Okay. Now, you tell me, if 103 is a chore, then 102 can also be a chore.
Yes.
Mutually, they will say, Nala ek, why are you showing 40,000 to government? You also show 3,000. I will also show 3,000. So in our building, fair rent will be? In fact, a building committee member will take a meeting. Nobody should hire a tenant who is paying more than 3,000 check rent. Balance rent we will take in cash. Because if one person takes the rent in check, all will be caught. Hello?
Yeah.
And therefore, 40,000 rent, fair rent in our building, 3,000 check, balance in cash. If tenant is ready to give that, then they only give house on tenant, otherwise we will not allow, society will not allow. Hum sab chor society. Okay?
Yes.
Possible?
Yes.
Therefore, government said, only if we trust on fair rent, market rent, that can be manipulated because that is in the hands of assessee. Yes. Alright? And therefore, always compare fair rent with municipal value. Municipal value. Now what is municipal value? Municipal value is the annual value determined by municipal authority. Municipal value is the annual value of your house property determined by municipal authority. Local authority, for us it is Bruha Mumbai Mahanagar Palika. Alright, for some people it is Kalyan Dombivli Mahanagar Palika. Alright, Kalyan Dombivli Municipal Corporation, Thane Municipal Corporation. Alright, in Kerala we are having Kottayam Municipal Corporation, Kochi Municipal Corporation. So there are municipal corporation. In village level we are having Gram Panchayat. In some military area we are having Cantonment Board. Hello? Alright, so we are having local bodies and in this local authorities, municipal authorities. So to manage your city, hello, they also take taxes. To manage your city, they also take taxes. So what type of management my municipal authority does? So I will give you example. National highways are constructed by central government. Hello?
Yes.
National highways, NH, are constructed by central government. State highways are constructed by state government. Alright. But this Subhash Road, inside road, is not national highway. Not state highway. So this is an inside road in cities. Alright. That is constructed and maintained by local authority. Okay. Second example. Your militaries, Navy, soldiers, armed forces, those are paid by central government. Police, Maharashtra police, Mumbai police. Alright, state wise. So that is state government. Alright. So state government have their own military, they like, and we are also in state also we are having law and order. And at national level, we are having military system, defense. Alright. Next, there are state hospitals, state government hospital. There are central government hospitals or medical schemes. Hello?
Yeah.
And there are local authority hospitals also. Okay? Next, education. Education. There are central government school. There are state government school. And then there are local authority school also. Alright. Water line that comes to your house is not central government, is not state government, it's local authority. Alright. Wastage, drainage pipeline or your sewage pipeline. Alright. That is also maintained by your local authority. City, keeping city clean is a responsibility of local authority. What I am trying to tell you here is that your central government is also providing you services. State government is also providing you services. Central government taking central taxes, income tax, excise, custom, central GST is taken by central government because they are providing you services. State GST, state VAT, land revenue tax. So there are taxes which is collected by state government. Central government, state government, both are having their taxes. Don't you think even local authority should have taxes? One of the local authority tax that we pay is municipal tax. One of the tax that we pay to local authority is municipal tax. Hello?
Yes.
Alright. Municipal tax is also known as the property tax. Municipal tax also known as?
Property tax,
local tax, you know, then municipal authority tax, municipal corporation tax. So there are lot of names of this tax. Municipal tax. Am I clear? Hello? To that tax, that tax will be in percentage, 8%, 10%, 12%. To compute tax amount, your municipality, municipal corporation will have one value. That value is municipal value. Now you tell me, will they manipulate in municipal value just for your safety? No. So can central government trust that value? Yes or no? Alright, but that value is outdated value. That value is sometime 10 years they have not increased that particular value. Therefore, we cannot only rely on municipal value. Hello, we cannot rely only on. So what government is doing? Government saying, okay, we will take both values. We will not fight for fair rent, at the same time we will not fight for municipal value. We will say both, check both. Alright, and take whichever is higher. Take whichever is higher. So take fair value, take fair rent, take municipal value, and out of those two take whichever is higher. Am I clear? Alright. So let us assume fair rent of our property is 1 lakh. Okay. And municipal value is 1 lakh 50. So what will come out of column? 1 lakh 50. Whichever is higher. Alright. In Marathi movies, or some local regional movies, in Hindi movies also you must have seen, there will be one villain type of guy in each village. Yes or no?
Yes.
There will be one big village. A richest guy in that particular village will be a villain.
Yeah.
Alright. Known for exploitation of other villages. Alright. In Hindi it is known as a zamindar or saukar.
Yeah.
Alright. So there will be one big house of that guy, car and all, you know, like these builders, and then, you know, like security guard, he will have, and he will be having attitude, lot of attitude. And then poor villagers will be standing there for some loan, some work, alright. So this kind of scene we people have seen lot of time, okay. Now this small farmers wanted a loan. Obviously he will go to zamindar or saukar, alright. The zamindar will give him loan by mortgaging a house, his house, okay. And then he will charge exploitative rate of tax, not normal rate of tax, rate of interest. Alright. And that rate of interest will be so overburdened. Alright. That after few years, this house will be taken over by, legally, will be taken over by this zamindar. Yes or no?
Yes.
Not only this house, this house, this house, this house. So lot of houses he will take over. That's what he does. Exploit, give them loan, keep them happy for some years, and then start taking their property, take possession, take legal ownership. If they don't give, kill them. This kind of movies we have seen. If it happened in movie, that means it was happening in reality also. Alright. And then the zamindar, because he has owned this particular house property now, a farmer will not vacate the property. See, in today's world, migration from one city to another city, one village to another village, one state to another state, one nation to another nation is possible. Because of literacy, it is possible. Because of democracy, it is possible. I'm talking about 70, 80 years, 100 years, 200 years. That time it was not possible. People will die, but they will not migrate. Hello? They will die there, but they will not migrate. You understand? So now these people, they don't have ownership, but they have to stay in that house. So they will be paying rent to zamindar. Yes or no? Now that rent will be how, like how he will charge, will he charge market rent or more than? More than. Exploit, na? He is a villain. Assumption, he is a villain. So he has to exploit them. So he will be charging very high rent. So when Britishers came and Britishers observed this one of the problem. Alright. It's not Britishers did all things wrong. Okay, 90 things they did wrong, but 10 things they did right also. Alright. One of the right thing that they did, that they created law for us. India was a country without laws. There was no law. Alright. It was ruled by rulers. King. Maharaj. Whatever Maharaj will say. Right. Today Maharaj is happy, so concession. Tomorrow Maharaj is angry, tax. If you shout against Maharaj, cut. No democracy. Okay. So one of the gift that we got from Britishers is democracy. Alright. One of the gift that we got, that various laws, majority of Indian laws are drafted by them. Alright. And that's what appreciation I have for them. All the other things they did wrong. Alright. But somebody has to control this zamindar. Somebody should control it. Britishers control it by passing Rain Control Act. By passing Rain Control Act. Now Rain Control Act is not applicable to all villages, all towns of India. Selected. So sometime it is applicable, sometime it is not applicable. So sometime in question they will give rent as per Rain Control Act, sometime they will not give. If they don't give, that means there is no Rain Control Act applicable, or it is irrelevant now. Why it is irrelevant now? Because now people are literate, people are not acting like a zamindar and saukar. There was a time when it was possible. Now everybody is literate, everything is documented, everything is legal. Hello? You understand? So now it might have become irrelevant, but there was a time when it was relevant. Am I clear? Alright. That rent is known as a standard rent. That rent is known as a standard rent of your property that we are talking here is 1,20,000. Can you charge more than 1,20,000? Will this act allow you to charge more than 1,20,000? No. All the fair rent is 1,50,000 or municipal is 1,50,000, but you are not technically allowed to charge more than 1,20,000. That's what central government understand, and therefore central government says, please compare this particular value with standard rent. Please compare this particular value with standard rent. Let us assume standard rate 1,20,000. Okay. Out of these two, take whichever is lower. Okay. So what is lower amount? 1,20,000. That amount is expected rent. That amount is? What are we doing? You understand? We are trying to find out rent earning capacity of your property. We are trying to find out rent earning capacity of your property. Till now we have not compared with actual rent. You can understand, we have started computing income of the house property, but we have not computed rent, because the name of the head is not rent from house property. The chapter name is income from house property, and there is a difference between rent from house property and income. I'm not teaching you rent from house property. I'm trying to teach you income from house property, and income from house property in house property head is not real income. Hello. It is not real income. We are taxing notional income. What are we taxing? Notional. We haven't compared our real rent till now. Hello. This is not your real rent. And therefore house property is the head where we don't tax real rent. We tax notional income. Notional means which is not real. It's not national income. Huh? Notional. Hello? Notional means something which is not real. Okay. So this, see, just to compare this head with other heads. Just comparison. Alright. If something like this, they put in salary here, thank God it is not there. If something like this,